Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss marine ecosystem and various concepts related to the marine ecosystem, including abiotic component, biotic component, and various types of marine ecosystem. Okay, and the ecosystem that can include in the marine ecosystem. So the learning objective of today's discussion is to study various components, that is abiotic and biotic, and their interaction in marine habitat. And the learning outcomes of today's discussion is, after completing discussion, student able to understand various abiotic component of marine ecosystem and biotic component of marine ecosystem, and interaction between biotic component in relation to feeding in marine habitat. So first of all, we need to understand about classification in the marine environment on the basis of habitat and mobility. So on that basis, there are various scientific terms can be used, like planktons, nectons, benthos. Okay, so all the floaters can be termed as planktons. Okay, and all the swimmers called nectons. Okay, that found in the marine environment, and the bottom dwellers. Okay, that creeping on the bottoms or the surface. Okay, are called benthos. Okay. And planktons, like the small and microscopic organism drifting or floating in the sea or fresh water. Okay, so all that include in the planktons. Okay, so the most biomass on earth consists of planktons. Okay, or either phytoplanktons or zooplanktons. Okay, and these term use for the like microscopic algae or autotrophs comes under the phytoplanktons, and heterotrophic organism, and protozoans, tiny animals, larvae of larger animals, all these comes under the zooplanktons. Okay, and the bacterial community comes under the bacterioplankton. Okay, and the virus that infect bacteria and eukaryotic cells called viroplanktons. Okay, so these are the various terms that you need to understand. Okay, phytoplanktons, zooplanktons, bacterioplanktons, viroplanktons, and some other terms also are used while we study the planktons. Okay, like holoplanktons. Okay, so the holoplanktons means entire lives as planktons that found in the sea. Okay, like algae, protozoans, small microscopic animals. Okay, so the both phytoplankton and zooplanktons combined can be called as holoplanktons. Okay, and another term, meroplanktons, used for part of lives as planktons. Okay, so these are the organism that has some part as a planktons. Okay, in their life cycle. Okay, so these are called meroplanktons. Okay, not holoplanktons, because like juvenile or larval stage in the planktons. Okay, like lobsters, some fish species has some part of lives as planktons. Okay, so these are called meroplanktons. Okay, and macroplanktons, as the name suggests, large floaters. Okay, so like jellyfish, sargassum. Okay, and picoplanktons, they are the very small floaters. Okay, like bacterioplanktons. Okay, so for these very small floaters, the term used picoplanktons. Okay, so these terms are very important. Okay, and another category that found in the marine habitat, nectons. Okay, so these are the independent swimmers. Okay, that swim independently. Okay, and most adult fish and squid comes under this category or nectons. And marine reptiles also are good swimmers, so they are also nectons. And marine mammals, okay, also comes under the nectons. Okay, and benthos. So benthos are the, they live on the seafloor. Okay, so on the basis of their location. Okay, so these are the various terms can be used for the benthos, like epifauna. Okay, so epifauna that live on the surface of sea floor. Okay, so for these organisms, that term used epifauna. Okay, and infauna that live buried in the sediment. Okay, so these are the two different kind of animal. Okay, infauna and nectobenthos. So these are swim or crawl through water above a sea floor. Okay, so these are the slight difference of their existence. Epifauna, infauna and nectobenthos. And if we talk about the number of marine species, so more land species than marine species. Okay, so if we talk about the species diversity, okay, so species diversity is high on the terrestrial habitat. Okay, and ocean relatively uniform condition, therefore layer adaptation is required and layer speciation is required. Okay, so don't be confused with the fact that number of individual organisms is high in the marine environment, but their species diversity is less. Okay, but number of organisms is higher as compared to the terrestrial environment. Okay, so there are fewer different species in the ocean, but a greater number of individuals. Okay, so these are both are the different things. Okay, and majority of life on earth lives in the ocean, and diversity in the ocean is high. Also think about different types of fish like seahorse, shark. Okay, and marine species overwhelmingly benthic rather than pelagic. Okay, if we compare the number. And most of these will be in shallow coastal benthic area where there is a light and a lot of primary productivity is there. Okay. And marine organisms have lots of adaptation for surviving in the marine habitat. Okay, so let's see some of the adaptation. So the first one is physical adaptation. Okay. So the this physical adaptation like buoyancy. Okay, any marine organism has buoyancy, so they can float on the water surface, and even they can resist sinking. Okay, so different support structure in cold and fewer rather than warm. Okay, and more appendages, seawater. Okay, and smaller in size. Okay, so these are the some physical support in the marine organism. Okay. And adaptation to marine life. So some of other adaptation like oil in microorganism to increase buoyancy. Okay, so over time if these organisms die and sink to bottom, can become offshore oil deposit. Okay, so these are the some other adaptation that found in the marine habitat. And some other adaptation like streamlining important for larger organism, and less resistance to fluid flow, and their body has to be flattened type, and tapering back end, which is for this the term is fusiform. Okay, so see, these are the adaptation, okay, which are essential for adaptation to a marine habitat. Okay, and if we talk about the fin design, okay, so the vertical fins as a stabilizer. Okay, and dorsal and anal fins, and paired fins for steering and balance. Okay, like pelvic and pectoral fin, and tail fin, that is caudal fin for the thrust. Okay, so you have to see that the fin design, for each fin design has a different purpose. Okay, so this is also the adaptation in the marine habitat. And a narrow range temperature in ocean. Okay, so small variations like daily, seasonally or annually. Okay, there are small variation. Okay, as compared to the terrestrial habitat, there is small variation. And remember, it take longer to change water temperature than air temperature. Okay, because you know that the energy that required to change the temperature of water, okay, is high. Okay, that's why it cannot easily change over time. And deep ocean are nearly isothermal. This means that the temperature has almost the same for all the time. Okay. And cold versus warm water species. So the smaller in cooler sea water, and more appendages in warmer sea water. Okay, and the trophic organism grow faster. Okay, and live shorter and reproduce more often. Okay, and higher number of species in warmer sea water, not necessarily higher number of individual, and more biomass in cooler sea water, upwelling and polar water are much more productive, more planktons growth than tropical water. Okay. And adaptation to finding prey. Okay, so there are some adaptation also there, like most fish cold blooded, but some are warm blooded. Okay, and there is homeothermic, means body temperature above sea water temperature, and modification in the circulatory system is there. Okay, mainly in the fast swimming fish. Okay, so these are some other adaptation to finding a prey. Okay, and adaptation of deep water nectons, mainly fish that consume detritus or each other. Okay, and lack of abundant food, and some of the species has bioluminescence and fishing lures, and some of the organism or marine organism has large sensitive eyes, and stenothermals and urethermals. Okay, so stenothermals means organism that withstand small variation in temperature. Okay, typically live in open ocean. Okay, these are the stenothermals. And urethermals, organism withstand large variation in temperature. Okay, these live in the coastal waters. Okay, so these are the two other terms used for these marine life: stenothermal and urethermals. And another term, stenohalines. Okay, so some of the organisms withstand only small variation in salinity. Okay, and typically live in open ocean. These organisms are called stenohaline. And urehaline, so organisms withstand large variations in salinity, typically live in coastal waters. Okay, for example, estuaries. Okay, and extracting mineral from sea water, and so for this high concentration to low concentration, this is a general concept everyone knows. Okay, and the cell membrane permeability to nutrient, for example, waste passes from cell to ocean. Okay, so these organisms has can withstand osmotic balance. Okay, and osmotic pressure, that means less concentrated to more concentrated solution. Okay, so these organism has a special transporter in their membrane. Okay, in their skin membrane, so that it can continuously flow out salt. Okay, so that they maintain the osmotic pressure. And if we talk about the dissolved gases, so some animal extract dissolved oxygen from sea water through gills. Okay, so most of the fish has this capabilities. And adaptation to marine life, so water transparency, many marine organisms okay, and some marine organisms are nearly transparent to avoid predation. So this is also the adaptation, transparency. And adaptation, other adaptation like camouflage. Okay, camouflage means some organism has capacity to hide. Okay, and change their color to save from predating. Okay, so and counter shading and disruptive coloring. Okay, so these are some more adaptation found in the marine life organism. And water pressure and increase about 1 atmosphere with every 10 meter deeper. Okay, okay. So many marine organisms do not have inner air pocket. So collapsible rib cage they have, like whale. And some other division on the basis of like pelagic that found in the open sea. Okay, so open sea area of the sea is called pelagic habitat. Okay, and neritic means less than 200 meter depth. Okay, and benthic that is seafloor, you know, and sub neritic and sub oceanic, and another classification is scheme euphotic and dysphotic and aphotic. Okay, so some other characteristics also we have to discuss today. Like marine ecosystem is characterized by the many biotic and abiotic component, okay, which is essential part of today's discussion. So the biotic component are organisms and their species, okay, and predators, parasites, competitors, okay, and mates. And the abiotic component include both physical and chemical component, okay, like temperature, concentration of nutrients, sunlight, turbulence, salinity, density. Okay, so the following are the properties that affecting the life in the sea and ocean, like quality of seawater, skeleton shape, size of organism, the buoyancy, gravity, and temperature of water, density of water, light penetration water, availability of nutrients, water turbulence, hydrostatic pressures. All these are the abiotic component that affect marine life. And marine environment have altogether different kind of physical condition for life to survive. Okay, and majority of marine plants are floating species, and they are microscopic. Okay, so these are include phytoplanktons and zooplanktons, and many marine animals are invertebrates. Okay, if we compare the total organism that found in the marine habitat, and they do not have a massive skeleton. Okay, and for floating and swimming, marine life require little energy, and water, which is fundamental constituents of all living organisms, is available in plenty within these marine environment. Okay, so there is no water scarcity there. And temperature is yet another parameter which do not vary as drastically as seen on land or in the air. Okay, as we compare the terrestrial habitat, as much less variation in the temperature as compared to the air or terrestrial habitat. However, there are certain properties which are less favorable for life in the sea and ocean, and plant growth in the sea is limited by light. So it is a fact that 50% of the total solar radiation which penetrate into the sea surface gets disappeared rapidly within a few meter of depth. Okay, and even much of the marine environment is in perpetual darkness. There is no light penetration is there, and under such circumstances, many of the marine life depend on the availability of essential nutrients only. And it is also to be noted that the zone just below the sea surface experience the maximum environmental fluctuation. If we talk about the ocean, so the word ocean means are the huge volume of sea water belonging to the hydrosphere. Ocean cover more than 70% of the earth's surface. Okay, so that's why the number of organisms is very large as compared to the terrestrial habitat. So about 99% of all the water available on earth are in the ocean. And ocean contains both valuable and much needed natural resources, like they are source of food, energy, minerals, and they are serve as a waterways for ship to transport people and carry cargo between continents. Okay, and the primary role of ocean and sea lies in maintaining the global climate by regulating the air temperature and by supplying the moisture for rainfall. Okay, so see, so it is a very important part of the climate, and without ocean life would not have originated in our planet. And when compared to the land-based terrestrial ecosystem, the marine ecosystem have certain unique feature. Okay, like the oceanic environment is very wide. Okay, covering approximately 75% of the earth's surface, and the oceanic system are very deep, in which life extend to all depth, even where there is no light. Life also exists at that place. And the water masses of the sea and ocean are continuous. Okay, There is not a way. So there are long 1,000 kilometers of water continuously present in the sea. So the water is in continuous movement in both vertical and horizontal dimension. Okay, which create waves. So the water is salty with an average salt content of 35 gram per liter, and the concentration of dissolved nutrient is very low. And the creature living on land needed to deal with the gravity, dehydration, great temperature variation, and many other factors which are normally not encountered in the marine life. Okay, and the marine environment divided into the various region like pelagic environment, epipelagic environment, mesopelagic zone, bathypelagic zone, abyssopelagic zone, benthic environment. Okay, so the distribution of marine life include the study of planktons, phytoplanktons, zooplanktons, nectons, and the benthos. Okay, and the temperature fluctuation, as we have to discuss here, is minimum in ocean water as compared to the other streams or okay, and Arctic water are colder and tropical water are warmer. Okay, so this is another point which you need to remember. And the variation is seasonal and diurnal, so there are not much variation as compared to the terrestrial habitat. And ocean animals show a varied response to the temperature, and there are two kind of animal. Okay, on the basis of thermostasis, so steno-thermal animals and urethermal animals. So steno-thermal animals, the animals which live within 20 degree range, and urethermal animals, the animal which can withstand the wide range of temperature variation. And the cold water forms also show an increase there in size. And the surface temperature of the oceanic water vary from -2 degrees near the north and south poles to about 30 degrees near the equator. Okay, and in the polar region, the surface sea water freeze, and the western tropical Pacific has the warmest surface water, and ocean current affect the surface temperature also. And the ocean temperature also vary with depth. So in general, the temperature falls as the depth increase. Okay, so the as the depth is increased, the colder the temperature of water, because light penetration is also decreased as we have to go down in the sea. And light is very essential for the marine life. So for photosynthesis, heating, radiation, and vision are related to this factor. Okay, light. And it determines the plant and animal life in the marine habitat and depend on the angle of incidence of light. And perpendicular rays go deeper into the ocean that based on the intensity of the light that enter into the water body of marine ecosystem. Okay, so on the basis of the penetration, the different differentiated into the three zones. Okay, euphotic zone. This zone extend up to 100 meter depth, and illuminated zone or production zone, because there are primary productivity high and there are lots of phytoplankton, and primary consumer and secondary consumer is there. And another is dysphotic zone. That zone lies between 100 and 200 meter depth, and weakly lighted, and secondary consumer live with a few primary consumer, and their plant life found in the dysphotic zone. Okay, and another zone is aphotic zone, above 200 meter depth. Okay, so there is no light in aphotic zone, there is no producer or found in the aphotic zone. Okay, there is no photosynthesis take place in the aphotic zone. Okay, so that's why the secondary consumer feed on other animal found in the aphotic zone. Okay, and another is euphotic zone, which is the uppermost layer of the world oceans. Okay, euphotic zone. So apart from ocean, there are another region found in the marine habitat, which is called estuaries. Okay, so estuaries are the coastal area where the saline water of the ocean meets with the fresh water of the river. Okay, so this region is called estuaries. And estuarine habitat are different from the marine habitat. Okay, so that's why it is usually very productive because of the accumulation of nutrient from the large catchment of the river, and where the fresh water meet with the salty water. Okay, so this region also has a productivity and the high productivity as compared to the ocean or deep ocean. And estuaries offer good fishing ground as the water column in shallow and easily approachable, and these are the breeding habitat for variety of shrimps, prawn species, oysters, fishes. Okay, and they also provide sheltered harbors for ship and their traffic. And estuarine water are used for cooling of water in power generation plant. Okay, so that's why it has importance for another way. And an estuary is a semi enclosed coastal body of water that has a free connection with the open sea at one side and a river on the other side. And the circulation of water in any estuary depend on the amount of fresh water outflow and the strength of the tidal current and the amount of vertical mixing. That's why it is different as compared to the marine habitat that has salty water, while the estuaries has water intermediate between the fresh and salty water, okay, which is called blackish water. And estuarine water is therefore salty or brackish in quality. Okay, strictly they are a deep funnel shaped mouths, and they are complex ecosystem comprising of three zones. Okay, the polyhaline zone, which has low salt, mesohaline zone, which has medium salt, and oligohaline zone, which is fully saline. Okay, so this is three region we can distinguish in the estuarine habitat. And the marine side is called a lower estuary, and it has a free connection to the sea with a salinity exactly equal to that of oceanic water, okay, and salty water. And it is called a polyhaline zone, and the total dissolved salt for this zone may range from the 30 to 35 ppt, okay, parts per trillion. And the middle estuary, which is subjected to a mixing of salt and fresh water, is called is the mesohaline zone, and the salinity of this zone may be around 15 ppt, 15 parts per trillion in the water. And the upper or fluvial estuaries, which is characterized by the flow of fresh water, is known as oligohaline zone. Okay, so these are the distinct zone found in the estuarine habitat, and the level of salinity in such zone may be around 0 to 5 ppt. Okay. And ecologically, an estuary is an area of dynamic biogeochemical activities if we compare the other habitat. And estuaries are critical for the survival of many species of bird, mammals, fish, and other wildlife. And river and streams drain into the estuaries, okay? And they bring in enormous amount of nutrients from uphills or uplands. And plants use these nutrients along with the sun radiant energy and CO2 and H2O to manufacture food, okay, which increase the primary productivity. And as long as the nutrient rich fresh water flows toward the estuaries will remain productive. Okay, and estuaries may be small or large depending upon their dimensions, size, shape, and the quantity of river staying inside and flowing inside. So the sediment carried by the streams are also dropped into the water mass of estuaries, and continuous sedimentation may shorten the dimension of the estuaries, especially in the upper reaches. Okay, that's why it looks like a funnel. And estuary is also considered as a maritime nursery. It is a place where young fish and few other organisms are protected from predators and competitors, which may not be able to enter into the low salinity water. Okay, so it is, has significance for these type of organisms. And the biota of estuaries are classified as producers and zooplanktons, and benthic invertebrates. Okay, so these are the biota of estuaries and fish and bird and wildlife. Okay, so the producer include like diatoms, dinoflagellates, green algae. These are the phytoplanktons, and red algae, green algae, brown algae. Okay, so these are the macro algae which are also because these are the large types of algae which can produce a weed, and benthic diatoms comes under the micro algae. Okay, so these are the producers of estuarine habitat. Okay, and even sea grasses also are the common in the estuaries. Okay, and the emergent plants include Spirtina, Juncus, Betis, Celonia. Okay, these are the plants that found in that habitat. Okay, so these are the producers. Okay, and second is zooplanktons. So these are the grazing herbivores and carnivores, like copy pod, larva fish, and fish eggs. Okay, and larval invertebrates like oysters, clams, corals, and jellyfish. Okay, and ctenophores, which are very abundant in plankton of estuaries. Okay, ctenophores. And the benthic invertebrates include like clams, oysters, mussels, snails. Okay, and polychaete worms, amphipods, decapods, like crabs, shrimps, lobsters. Okay, so all these are the benthic invertebrates. And the fish include the migratory fish, which enter by the inlet, are anadromous fish, and striped bass and salmon, and spotted sea trout and red drum. Okay, these are the fish. And juvenile fish predominate in the estuarine at nursery level, and estuaries are a very important feeding area for many migratory birds. Okay, like the estuarine shores show plovers, skimmers, gulls, oysters, catchers, terns, pelicans, ducks, ospreys. Okay, and reptiles like sea turtles. Okay, that consume fish. Okay, invertebrates and sea grasses. And another ecosystem that found in the marine habitat, which is called onshore ecosystem. Okay, so the marine ecosystem are distributed as onshore and offshore ecosystem. Okay, so the onshore ecosystem are very typically ecosystem subjected to the overlasting action of waves and tidal influences. Okay, because they are like a seashore. Okay, and the life on the onshore ecosystem are always under the dynamic impact of various factors, including human interventions also there. Okay, and they are called foreshores. And foreshores are the land bordering the sea and ocean. Okay, so the geomorphology of foreshore may vary from place to place. Okay, and based on the slope of continental margin. So foreshore are the forefront of continents and facing the action of waves and tides directly, and they are the zone of land sea interactions. Okay, so there are high tides and low tides also there, and the abiotic factors controlling the fauna and flora of the foreshore, like geomorphic factors like width, length, slope, thickness, geology of coastline. Okay, affect the flora and fauna of foreshore, and hydrographic factor like water and its salinity also affect the flora and fauna, and light, temperature, air, wind, humidity, tides, waves. Okay, all these factors affect the flora and fauna that found in the sea on shore. Okay, and the notable foreshore ecosystem are sandy foreshore, shingle foreshore, lagoons, muddy foreshore, salt masses, and rocky foreshore. Okay, so depending on the types of edaphic factors. Okay, type of edaphic. Okay, factors. Okay, these are the various force for habitat. And another habitat that also include in the marine habitat, beach. Okay, so a beach is the land bordering the sea, and is defined as the accumulation of sediment led by the waves and tides, and it usually consists of sand or gravel. And an active beach is the area of loose sediment subject to transport by wind, waves and currents, is divided into the three regions. Okay, and the region are the backshore, foreshore and the offshore. Okay, so a beach is characterized by the coastal upland, which can be dune, a cliff, a soil embankment, and a fossil bum, or an engineered structure such as seawall or rivetment. Okay, so these are the some other structures that found at the beach. And another component that found in the marine habitat, these are the coral reefs. Okay, so coral reefs are a major geological structure built by biological activity. Okay, and coral can be seen along some of the beaches, looking as a piece of rock like material. Okay, and the coral are a skeleton of many tiny sea animals, living side by side, and each one of these animals is known as coral, okay, or polyp. And the coral polyp is a soft, almost transparent animal, which builds its own skeleton outside its body. And since it has no backbone, so it is an invertebrate. So a coral live in this structure, okay, that found at the sea. And coral which produce a hard skeleton are called stony coral. So on the basis of these, the stony corals like stony corals, finger corals, fungus corals, brain corals, tube corals, rose corals, stegon corals, okay, lettuce leaf corals. Okay, so outer structure is almost same, but the inner organisms that live in these corals are different. Okay, and soft corals like sea fern and bushy soft coral, sea feather, black coral. Okay, so the live hard corals can be divided into the major forms like branching, massive, tabulate or flat. Okay, depending on their shape. So what are the importance of corals that found in the marine habitat? Okay, so the coral sea are typical ecosystem, and most of them are shallow marine, and a few are deep marine. Okay, and coral ecosystem encompass a good platform for variety of natural resources, and coral sea are good spot for ecotourism, and coral life are unique and exhibit a natural museum of wonderful marine life. Okay. And okay, now this is a difference. Now you put first question is the term used for marine habitat floaters. Okay, planktons, nectons, benthos. Okay, so which term used for marine habitat floaters? Okay, so the planktons are the marine habitat floaters. Okay, and the term used for marine habitat swimmer. Okay, so the nekton term used for marine habitat swimmers. Okay, so the option B is correct. And the term used for marine habitat bottom dwellers. So so the benthos terms used for the marine habitat bottom dwellers. So the option C is correct. And zooplankton include heterotrophic protozoans, tiny animals, larvae of larger animals. Okay. Or microscopic algae or autotrophic. Okay, so the correct option is A, because these are the tiny animals. Okay, and larvae of larger animals. Okay, so the option A is correct, zooplankton. Okay, while the microscopic algae and autotrophs comes under the phytoplanktons, and phytoplanktons include microalgae and autotroph. Okay, so the option B is correct. And soft corals एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सॉफ्ट कोरल्स आर सी फैंस, बुशी सॉफ्ट कोरल्स और सी फेदर्स. ओके, सो ऑल दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सॉफ्ट कोरल. ओके, सी फैंस, बुशी सॉफ्ट कोरल्स एंड सी फेदर. थैंक यू.